Hey, what's up? This is Marcos from P.O.D, and you are listening to Collision Radio. Hello?
Hi, Marcos. It's Kat.
Yes, hello.
How are you?
I'm good. I'm getting these random numbers calling me, and I'm like, Providence, Rhode Island, huh? And then the other one was somewhere else. I don't know.
Well, I'm in Australia.
I couldn't notice. You don't have an accent. I'm joking around.
Sorry about that. I was kind of born with it. But I suspect.
Whereabouts in Australia are you?
I'm actually near Melbourne.
Oh, yeah. I just saw the news about some wacko running people down there.
I know. I was there an hour before it happened. I'm so glad I went home. It was shocking.
Hey, yeah. Now you know what it feels like to kind of be American.
Yeah. Well, we're starting to get the idea. Trust me. It's not a good thing.
It's not. Garbage.
It is. But I guess this is something that kind of inspires you guys to write, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean, Youth of the Nation were given birth due to a tragedy, a local school shooting here many, many years ago, and still pretty relevant today. Mm. And that song kind of has a timeless energy to it, you know?
Yeah. Which actually, that album, Satellite, it's not only probably your biggest album, but it was released on the day of the attacks on the trade centers in America, and it didn't get lost.
Yeah.
It somehow didn't get lost in the pile. It somehow actually became the biggest album you had.
Yep. I mean, everybody, you know, at that time, a lot of people's records that came out on that same day, they failed.
Mm.
And people gravitated to ours. So, you know, we're really gracious and thankful for that record. It's our biggest album to date, and it's given us the long career that we have, and, you know, we've been able to do many other records, and we're actually working on a new one now. Should be coming out around June, summertime, near the U.S., and we just signed with Mascot Records, so we're lucky to still be doing it.
Awesome. So you're releasing an album like a couple of months after you tour Australia, so hopefully you're going to be sneaking in one or two new tracks in there.
We plan on making a couple. I mean, we plan on trying to get back there again. I mean, I don't know if we'll get back there in the same year, but at least on the new record cycle, we'll do this one, you know, we'll play Satellite from beginning to end with some hits, and then once we drop the new album, we plan on making a trip around the earth one more time, a couple more times.
Awesome. That is so cool to know, because you guys, you were here not too long ago, but it was a co-headlining tour, wasn't it?
We went on tour with Disturbed and Alter Bridge.
Yeah.
And then we came back and did a couple spot dates for a couple different festivals, and then we haven't been back since. It's been quite some time.
Well, we miss you too, so we're looking forward to April 2018.
So are we.
Awesome. But like with this album Satellite, I mean, you guys were in a really good position because there were a lot of bands in the early OOs whose debut albums, you know, became their biggest albums. But this was actually your fourth album. So you guys kind of knew what you were doing when this hit you. So do you think that helped you to handle it?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I think it's human nature to always strive to do more or to do better, if that means anything. I mean, we just love, you know, performing and entertaining and being real and writing music that is from the heart and that is relevant for the time. And we want to write positive music that inspires people, you know, to be good to their fellow man, you know, to wake up and have good vibes and good energy. You know, we want to inspire people, and music's a good outlet for that. And we've tried to always use that as one of the main driving forces for our band.
Yeah, I think it's not just the words that you use, it is the music too. There's just this pumping up, making you feel like you're getting ready to go and take on the world feel in your music.
Been told that many times. It's got a triumphant vibe for sure.
Yeah, awesome.
You know, and that's on purpose. I mean, we're that band. We like to have big choruses and big anthemic sing-alongs if possible, you know, and rock at the same time.
Yeah, cool. Can I actually ask, because you did leave the band for 3 years, is there a reason you decided to leave at that time, and what did you do?
Well, I started the band with the drummer in 92. It was a sticky situation. It was a business deal, and, you know, depending on who you ask, I left or, you know, I got kicked out or whatever. I'm just going with it. It was time in our, a period of time in our history as a band that needed to happen, I guess, for us to grow as individuals and collectively. So there was really, it was, we were young, dumb on all fronts, and we learned from it. And we have been back together now over 10 years.
Hmm. And stronger for it.
Yeah, and it's the, I mean, there's two records that I wasn't a part of, but everything else I've been a part of, and we're still doing it. We're still grinding it out, and we love what we do. We love to perform for the people, the different cultures around the world.
Yeah. Well, other than, you know, someone who left in the early days and your temporary replacement, you guys have been a solid unit since 92, pretty much. So, like, did you know each other from school? How did you actually meet?
Me and the drummer started the band. We had a mutual friend that introduced us. And, you know, he knew that I was trying to start a band and I needed a drummer. And I asked him if, I was asking all my friends at that time if they knew of a drummer, because it was me and my other buddy who was playing bass. And we needed a drummer. And he introduced me to him, drove me over to his house, and that was it. Me and him started jamming out from that day on, and next thing you know, when we first started, I was doing the vocals and playing guitar, and it was more of a thrash metal outfit, and we wanted to mix in a little more, you know, of our culture, our Southern California vibes. We all listened to rap, we all listened to reggae, and I did a majority of the screaming, and we were playing predominantly just thrash metal, and he had an idea. He's like, hey, well, my cousin, he raps. We should give him a shot. He can be the front man. And I was like, hey, let's do it. And that's how it all began. He started showing up at rehearsals, and he was super, super shy. Our first show that we played together as a band, it was like a Jim Morrison vibe. Like, Sonny had his back. Like, if you ever watch the movie, the Oliver Stone movie with about Jim Morrison and the Doors, he was really shy and bashful at first and wouldn't turn around and sing to the crowd. Well, that was Sonny. And Sonny's still pretty mellow guy, but he's a beast when he gets on that stage.
Yeah.
And it's been awesome to see everybody grow into men together all these years, you know, because we were basically mid-late teenagers when we started jamming together.
Yeah.
And now we're all dads, and we all have kids, and we're grown men. And we still get to do what we love around the world and make a living. So we're completely blessed to do that.
Can I ask what inspired you to, like, play guitar and start a band? Did you come from a musical family?
I did come from a musical family. My grandfather was a mariachi here in San Diego, and his big claim to fame was that he was able to play for President Roosevelt when he came to town. Mm. And it wasn't a thing for me, like, you know, when you have a bunch of friends where everyone like gets a guitar and everyone starts to play music together. It was just a solo thing for me. I was watching TV and I saw a concert on television. And before that, I wanted to be a pilot. So it just struck me and I was like, I want to play guitar. And my mother was like, guitar? Why? None of your friends play guitar. I was like, I just want a guitar for my 13th birthday. And, you know, we grew up really, really poor, and she had to save up money to help purchase my first guitar amplifier and guitar. And I kind of learned on my own, reading magazines. When I got the guitar, I was a little disappointed because I thought I was going to be able to shred and be this excellent guitar player. And I got it, and I was like, oh my gosh, I don't even know how to tune this thing. I don't even know what to do. But I played for hours and hours and hours. And it was players like Carlos Santana, The Edge from U2, metal bands like Iron Maiden, Metallica. They all played a major influence on me wanting to play guitar. And I'm just lucky and grateful that I'm able to do it today.
Yeah, that's great. We're lucky too that you're able to do it today. And you are going to
Thank you.
You are going to be doing it in April in Australia, starting the 17th in Melbourne, actually, at 170 Russell.
I'm so ready. So ready.
Well, we're ready too. Hopefully, you're coming to Melbourne first, so hopefully you're coming in a few days early.
Yeah, we need to talk about that. I don't know how the flights are getting booked, but that sounds like a good idea.
Well, if you do, let us know and we'll show you around. We'll try and find the safe areas to go.
I hear you.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to it. I know we all are looking forward to it. We've always asked, why haven't we returned? You know, what different management companies that we've been through, and, you know, we're finally going to get our chance to get back there, and hopefully it won't be so long a period of time for us to get back there. Like I said, hopefully we'll put a new record out and go back again. That's the plan. That's what's been discussed, so I hope so.
Well, you're not actually going to Perth this time. You're only going to Melbourne, Adelaide, Sydney, Brisbane, and the Gold Coast you'll be playing at. Tickets are from Metropolis Touring. Would you like to say something to your Aussie fans? Not that you need to talk them into coming out to see you, because I know there's a lot of people excited.
Well, I just want to say thank you for supporting us for all these years, and we hope to get down there more often, and we're grateful for all the support, and we're so looking forward to coming down and jamming and doing what we do in your country and in your city. So thank you very much for supporting our band through the years, and we'll see you soon.
Well, thank you, and like, this really is a classic album. There's some amazing tracks on it, and listening to it, it's definitely got a, you know, good memories in most of our lives, I think, from that period of time. Like, I've never associated it with the 9/11 attacks. Yeah, I think in Australia, you know, it's an album that we really clung to at the time, and because we weren't part of 9/11, I guess we didn't associate it with it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's cool.
The timing and everything for that record was, I don't even know how to explain it. It was just amazing how it all came out and how it did so well at that time period. Through all the tragedy, it definitely touched a lot of people's hearts and it encouraged a lot of people. And I'm grateful, and we're grateful as a band. So we can't wait to play that for everybody.
Because this is probably the album that got you out of America into the rest of the world.
Pretty much, yes.
Yeah.
We were just discussing how a lot of the songs on that record, we play like about 6 or 7 of them, but then the other 5, we haven't played in over 15 years or whatever. So we're doing our due diligence to learn our songs, and we're like, it's a trip, because what was I thinking back then, you know? Like, on the writing side of things, I'm like, I would have never written anything like that now, but it's going to be fun, and it's a fun task to be able to play that record from beginning to end.
Yeah, and we're really looking forward to it, and I'm sure that people will be able to catch you guys after the show, maybe hanging around the bar or something for a drink.
Oh, yeah, hey, we're ready.
Awesome.
You can't go down under and not have a drink.
Definitely not. Thank you so much. I've been looking forward to talking to you guys for quite a while now. Can't wait to see you in April, too, this album. It's, you know, great memories for a lot of us.
We can't wait to be there, and thank you for taking the time to show us some love. We really appreciate it.
Well, thank you for taking the time to show our country some love and bringing this album out here. It has been amazing.
You got it.
And I look forward to having a chat to you when you're coming to tour for the new album.
Yeah, that'll be cool. That'll be awesome.
Awesome. You have a great day.
You too. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.